My name is Daniela Magic and I'm a portrait photographer. If you don't know my work, I mainly focus on conceptual photography, fashion, and wedding photography. In the last 6 years of being a photographer, I tend to receive a lot of messages about Photoshop. And mostly people are asking me, how do I Photoshop skin? Or how do I make the colors look a certain way, or what is my process with Photoshop? It's always really difficult for me to answer these questions because I don't necessarily Photoshop every single image the exact same. If I'm Photoshopping a conceptual image, I might want to be a little bit more experimental and have a little bit more creativity and fun with the image. Whereas if I'm Photoshopping a wedding image for a client, I'm going to keep things a little bit more classic and fresh and pretty. I'm not always using the same process for each image, but I do have a set of tools that I really enjoy using when I'm Photoshopping an image. I wanted to mention that everybody uses Photoshop differently. I personally use Photoshop as a way to complete the full idea of what it is that I'm going for in my image. I use Photoshop to clean up things, to fix up light a little bit, and to change the color if I need to. Photoshop to me is like the icing of a cake. You need to have all the ingredients there before you can complete it. I use Photoshop as a way to enhance the subject. I'm never trying to change who they are, I'm just trying to fix up little details, such as a blemish or a little bit of a strange shadow. So today in this video, I'm going to show you my favorite Photoshop tools. Now, this isn't a step-by-step how to Photoshop something, and there isn't really going to be a final image in the end. I'm just going to show you the tools that I like to use and how they work. I'm hoping that this video will help anybody who might be a little bit confused with Photoshop, or just need to understand a little bit about different tools. So I'm going to start with this older image of my sister, and it's already been Photoshopped a little bit, but there are a few things that I know now that I didn't know back when I was Photoshopping this image. So what I want to start with first is my favorite tools for the skin. As you can see here, her skin is pretty good in this image, so there isn't too much that we're going to have to get rid of, but there are a few little speckles and things that I normally look at when I am Photoshopping an image of someone's face. The first tool that I love to use is the clone tool, and it looks like a stamp. So what I want to do with this tool is look up here, right at opacity, and set the strength of how I want this tool to work. It always depends on the image that I'm Photoshopping. In this case, I'm going to keep it at 100. And I'm not going to make this brush too big because I don't want a large area to be cloned. Just want to start with something a little bit smaller. So right now I'm going to say 104. Then I'm going to take areas from the other parts of the skin, and I'm going to get rid of a few of the speckles. Now this doesn't work for every single blemish on the face. Sometimes you're going to want to get in much smaller than 104. Let's say we set the brush to 50. And we zoom in really far. Okay. Let's set the brush even lower, so 24. We're gonna get in and we're just gonna look at these tiny little speckles. It's really good to blow up the picture on the screen so you can see all the little details. Now we can get an idea of what I've changed by going back.
Right now I'm not using any of these on layers. I'm just trying to show you a little bit about the tool. So you can use layers if you want to have a kind of like a history and if you want to go back and change things. So right now we're just focusing on the tool itself. So next we want to look at another skin tool, which is the Spot Healing Brush Tool, and it looks like a Band-Aid. So I use this for the even smaller little speckles that I might want to get rid of. And this is a process that takes a very long time. If I'm really going in on someone's face and I want to fix up all the blemishes, I'm going to spend a long time doing it. I mainly use this tool when I want to get rid of lines, like laugh lines, or little bits of hair, for example. And what you want to do is play around with these tools, and you want to change the opacity of these tools. You want to get to know what they do and what works best for you. Photoshopping a picture can take me anywhere from 1 hour to 5 hours to 7 hours. It all really depends on how I want the final image to look. And just because you are spending a lot of time photoshopping does not necessarily mean that your image is going to be drastically changed. It's just about the vision that you have and what you want your final image to look like. So we'll take a second here to look at what this tool has done for us. And you can really see a lot of change in the little speckles on her eye and her eyebrow. Best thing for you to do is to get to know these tools and to explore what they can do for your photography. Next, I'm going to get into the color. So a tool that I really like to use is called Curves. And you'll find Curves under Image, Adjustments, Curves. And again, this is something that you can do in layers as well. Sometimes I just use it right away to set the mood or the tone for my image. And then from there I use layers, or from there I start to adjust things. So what you want to do is play around with these tools and get to know exactly what they do and what they can do for your image. And I like to use small amounts of these tools. I don't want to go too far and do something that's too dramatic or too crazy. I want to keep things to a minimal. And you can go through the different colors and see what they can do for your image and how they can change your image. So keeping with color, another tool that I really like to use is called Selective Color. So again, you can find this in Image, Adjustments, selective color. You can also use this in layers as well if you want to trigger a specific color in your image. So again, just playing with the colors and looking and getting an idea and a feel for what it is that you want your image to look like. If there's a little bit too much yellow in the skin, you can drop that down. The next tool we're going to look at is called Liquify, and you can find Liquify in Filter, Liquify. You have to be very careful when you're using Liquify. You don't want to change the subject too drastically, unless of course that is what you are going for. I usually use only three set tools on the left hand side. But again, you can explore Liquify and try to find what it is that works for you in your photography. Forward Warp Tool is one of my favorite tools in Liquify, and it looks like a finger pointing. And again, I'm going to look over to the right side and set my brush and also my brush pressure. So what this does is pull certain parts of the image that I might just want to fix up just slightly. And again, I don't want to change her face too much from what she does naturally look like. I just want to fix things slightly. Another tool you can use is called the Pucker Tool. This does almost exactly what the Warp Tool does, just a little bit differently. And be careful with using these tools. You don't want to overdo it or change someone too drastically. This tool is good if you want to make something smaller, like a nose or an ear. Next is the Bloat Tool, and this does the opposite. So let's say I wanted to make her lips a little bit fuller. So here I'd use the Bloat Tool. Or her eye, for example. So it's really just little tiny details that you're focusing on. So now we can take a look at what the image looked like before and after. I'm not changing who she is or what she naturally looks like. I'm just enhancing the photograph and the angles the way that I think that they should be.
Enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. Also, please leave in the comments what you would like me to do in the next video, whether it be something about lighting, an inspirational video, or even just another Photoshop video. I would love to hear from you. Thank you.